Hi, folks. Somewhere it's written that angels long to look into the things contained in the Word, the mysteries contained in the Word. And yet often they don't see them, but they long to see them. But the Lord says for those who are found in Christ, we're sons. We're the children of the King. And He shows us everything. Can a man possess another man? Well, the man himself, certainly not. But the demons or the angels within that man certainly can. You are what you eat, right? If a man comes in contact with violence, hatred, abuse, he's liable to give back what he got, isn't he? He's liable to become what he eats. If he eats of violence all the time, if he eats of slander, you know, slander is violence. Slander is hatred. You know, gossip and all this kind of shit, you know, where telling stories about people that aren't true, spreading rumor and innuendo. Some people get their jollies doing that. Slander in the scripture is eating flesh. I don't like eating flesh. Gossip, it just makes everything worse. Participating with the devil. And we don't want to be participants with demons, do we? We don't want that. There's something. Demons, D-E-M-O-N-S. I think it's participants. P-R-T-I-C-I-P. T-S, I don't know, probably I can't spell worth a crap, but luckily these have spell check, at least mine does. there we go, 1 Corinthians, demons. It's in 1 Corinthians 10:20. The sacrifices of pagans are offered to demons, not to God. Demons are false ideas. And I don't want you to be participants with demons. One cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of demons as well. You cannot have a part in both the Lord's table and the table of demons. You wonder why I encourage people to read their Bibles and to study. Show themselves approved, rightfully dividing the word of truth. And it's because I meet too many people. I hear too many people talking about the right way, you know, about the Lord, about faith, and they make the mistake of eating from both the Lord's table and the table of demons, false ideas, which come from the father of lies, who is falsehood, the devil, a.k.a. Satan, Lucifer. Some people say, oh, it doesn't matter. Well, yeah, it does matter. It does matter. We should not ever want to participate with demons when we claim to be drinking of the Lord's cup, sitting down and eating at his table. The table, of course, is wisdom's upon that table. Understanding is upon that table. The gift of the Spirit is on that table. The gift of the Spirit is understanding. 1 John 5:20. I don't read that often, do I? I quote it quite a few times in my videos, but I don't actually read it to you very often. So I'm going to read it to you. 1 John 5:20. We know also that the Son of God has come and has given us, ding, 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 understanding. This is what he's given us. This is the gift. Understanding. Understanding what? Understanding the truth. That Jesus is Lord. Father Truth himself in bodily form. Given us understanding so that we may know him who is true. And we are in him who is true. Even in his Son, Jesus Christ. He, Jesus Christ, is the true God and eternal life. Many people say, oh, I believe in Jesus and I believe in God, but Jesus is not God. Well, guess what? You're in trouble. That's what you believe. You're in trouble. I'm not going to say any more about that. People will come up with many excuses for their ignorance, but there is no excuse for ignorance because the Lord promised that if we'd ask, he said, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and eat with him and he with me. In other words, he'll teach us if we just answer the knock. The knock. Pick up that Bible and read it. Ask the questions. What you don't understand, ask. He'll answer. Give him time. Sometimes, you know, you'll read something in the scriptures. You may pick up the Bible and open it to a place where, my goodness, within 10 seconds, you've got questions. And you're, well, what does this mean, Lord? What does that mean, Lord? And you think, oh, he's just going to, you're going to hear a voice out of nowhere, you know, telling you, hey, Ed, this is what it means, you know. No, that ain't going to happen that way. Sorry. But if you continue to read, it's like a little kid in grade school, in grade one, let's say. And he says to his teacher, he says, I don't understand microbiology. He heard the word somewhere, he didn't even know what it is. But this is his statement to his teacher. Well, tell me what microbiology is. And the teacher, she can't. He can't. But in due time, that child will learn what it's all about. As he progresses through his grades and is taught, he will come to understand what microbiology is all about. And the Bible's the same way. The Spirit is the same way. We grow in Christ. We don't just all of a sudden, bam, we're Christ. We're never Christ anyways. Christ is truth and love in his own one and only bodily form. It's Jesus, and we're not Jesus. But we grow up into Jesus, who is the head. Jesus is the Christ. And we grow up into him to be like him. He's our teacher. We're his students. A student is supposed to listen to his teacher. Well, how do you hear your teacher? We got whack jobs out there trying to tell us that just listen to whatever pops into your head. God, don't do that. Oh, just listen to your heart. Don't do that either. Try listening to what it says in the Word. This can be trusted. Believe you me, this and this can't. What did it say somewhere about Jesus knew? K-N-E-W, new man, in man. Well, I don't know if I can find this one or not. There may be a little blip in the screen here where I have to cut 25 minutes out of this thing while I search for this. Oh, there it is. Came up quick. John 2:25. Jesus did not need man's testimony about man, for he, Jesus, knew what was in a man. Yeah. Don't trust this and this. Trust this. This is tested. This is proven.